this observatory took place during a difficult economic situation. Economy was decreasing and very slow. This reflected on the energy consumption. On the price side, we see quite a lot of discrepancy between oil price that stayed high because of political tensions. Gas price, it is really a two-tiered market, with the US having low gas prices thanks to shale gas and conventional gas, and Europe having much higher gas prices because they are linked to oil prices. This accident has triggered a lot of thoughts on energy transition, meaning that thoughts on the future energy mix. Generally speaking, the future energy mix has a bigger share of gas and renewables and a smaller share of nuclear than before. This means also probably higher electricity prices and more CO2 emissions. If we look today at the landscape of renewables, we are seeing still an increase in wind power and solar. But those energies, especially solar, are not competitive today, so they need to be subsidized either through feed-in tariffs or through fiscal subsidies. With the sovereign debt problems in Europe, those subsidies are going down. And many renewable manufacturing companies have difficulties. Perhaps that the 2020 objective set by the EU Commission of 20% renewable in the energy mix are too soon, because to meet those objectives, we are importing cheap solar panels from China. And perhaps we should put more money in research and development in order to have our own competitive industry. If we look at the second objective on CO2 decrease, this will probably be met. Not so much because the emission trading system, the ETS system in Europe, is efficient. Today it is not. The prices are too low. But because of the slow economy of industries moving outside of Europe, or when they stay in Europe, having a lower production. If we look at the third objective, which is the energy efficiency objective, this also is difficult to be met as the renewable objectives. And today, projections are not leading to the 20% reduction. So there was, in June 2012, a recommendation of the EU that would oblige utilities to have their own customers decrease their energy consumption. And the aggregate decrease should be at least of 1.5% per year, each year starting in 2014. If not, there will be extra costs for the utilities. Now, if we look at the investments, this is a problem in Europe. There are huge investments to be done from now to 2020. It is evaluated to at least 1 trillion euros. We are not really seeing those investments starting in a significant way, because this economic situation makes them less indispensable. Finally, on the utility side, utilities were viewed as a very sustained sector. The crisis has shown that is less true, because utilities are impacted by their own clients, and especially industrial clients, difficulties. Today, utilities are also negatively impacted by other factors, for example, EU legislation, European legislation, as well as local national legislation, for example, taxes on nuclear. So in a certain way, there is a message to pass to regulators and governments saying, be careful and don't kill the goose that lays the golden egg, because utilities at one time will decide to shift their portfolio of assets and to leave Europe. In conclusion, utilities should also continue to improve their competitiveness, and we at Capgemini are there to help them.
People matter, results count.